National Innovation Strategy. The nation station Oman FM, with the cooperation of the Research Council, presents Innovation Roadmap, an introduction to National Innovation Strategy from the Research Council.
Hello and welcome to Innovation Roadmap. His Highness Sayyid Dr.Fahad bin Al-Jalanda Al-Sayed, Assistant Secretary General for Innovation Development and the Research Council, Chairman of the Supervisory Committee of the National Innovation Strategy, is our guest today. Welcome to the program. It's a very exciting journey, the Innovation Roadmap. How would you describe the National Innovation Strategy?
Well, first of all, thank you for this interview. The National Innovation Strategy is actually, as you describe it, we call it a master plan for innovation in Oman, where we hope, inshallah, that it draw the plan and the direction for innovation in the coming years for Oman, hoping to achieve some goals. We hope also to establish our innovation ecosystem, in which innovation will be a major pillar in the Omani economy, and it's part of what you call it knowledge economy in Oman.
When we look at knowledge economy, how would you describe the ideal?
Well, the knowledge economy basically is the knowledge which is based on the knowledge of the people, which is the Omanis and the rest at the end of the day. And I think since His Majesty came, that's the basis. We've gone through a very, major changes from starting from two schools. Now we have universities and all the governance. We have different specialized colleges, also technical and also in years. We say that all the youths, the Omani youths, and my generation and the earlier generation, they are educated, whether they are educated in the best universities in the West or whether they are educated in Oman, they are. If you go and see Oman today, walillah alhamd, is basically all the main jobs in the government and even the private sector is really done by Omanis, qualified Omanis. And that's basically, it's when we talk about innovation, it's actually the next logical evolution to what have been achieved in the past 47 years in Oman, where you have educated people, competent people, and with the know-how, and they basically should go to the next level where they should find solution, they will direct the way for the economy, and that's the norm basically in all the countries. And without having the proper education and then learning and the knowledge, it will be very difficult for people to do so.
When we look at the National Innovation Strategy, where would you say, which stage is it?
Well, basically we are now in the stage where the beginning of the implementation stage. We finished the scanning, the planning things, the writing of the documents, gathering momentum and involving the different stakeholders to be there. That was the second stage of the... We are in the third stage where we're starting now to introduce the and build awareness of the National Innovation Strategy with the public and the different government and the private sector. So we are now in the stage where we call it picking or harvesting the low-hanging fruits. That's a stage which we like. So we are in the beginning of the implementation stage.
And that would mean you've already interacted with individuals?
Yes. We basically, what we did from the beginning, we brought everybody. We tried to bring everybody on board in scanning, identifying the challenges and setting and drawing the way forward. And then basically once we agreed on it and test it against certain measure and bringing people to test it, then we wrote the document which have been looked at and approved. And then once it have been approved, now means we going to enter the implementation stage. And we did that by by having holding meetings and introducing to different entities, like we already talked to the Minister of Information, Minister of Education. We also talked to we have a presentation to the State Council. We started to give presentation to each entity. They are also what we call it partners. They are part of the stakeholders, informing them and make them know to understand their role, what they need to be done in within the innovation, national innovation strategy.
So from what I understand is, it's very different because a lot of people would think the strategy, the national innovation strategy, is something from the Research Council. But this is actually going out of the spectrum of the Research Council and bringing the whole country
together. Yeah, I think the approach was basically, building the ecosystem and the infrastructure of the innovation and the research is a mandate, is one of the core mandate of the Research Council. But there is no way, and there is no one country where innovation is actually owned by one. When we talk about innovation, we're talking about innovation in every sector. We're talking about innovation in the street. We're talking about innovation with the people. We're talking about innovation in every aspect. It's a culture. Mm-hmm. It's a mindset. So if you're going to limit it to one organization, basically you are going to frame it, and framing is not innovation. Innovation is thinking out of the box. Innovation mm-hmm. is trying to find solutions. And basically when we started to think about it, we said that usually strategy is basically built, it's done by certain entities, no matter what it is. But for those strategies to work, and part of the strategy is that entity, organization, have to hold every aspect, have to hold assets, in terms of financial assets, human capital, and everything, control it within the environment. Here we don't have that. We are talking basically about roles of different organizations, the government, the private sector, with the people, because those are the one going to do the role. Those are part of their mandate, core mandates. So in order for it to succeed, they have to understand and see how is their role, their mandate, the core businesses, will affect the whole overall
ecosystem.
Exactly. And that's why it's very important to bring them. This is when we said it's a master plan. It's a master plan and said, okay, let's say the Ministry of Education, for example, their core business is to educate youth. But their output is basically will affect everybody. It will affect higher education, it will affect the private sector, it will affect everybody. So once they understand and they direct their inputs to have a far much output, that will be understandable. And then also we have to understand is that we have to understand why it's very important to support the role and the mandate and the requirement of the Minister of Education to have a far much better output. And that's the way where it's not anymore, it's mine and I will do it. They said, no, actually it's yours, but basically I support you because I understand your output, your role will affect everybody and it will have a much better impact on Oman in general. And if you look at the competitiveness index on the Omanis, part of the things, there are two things. There is the inputs and the output. Actually in inputs, we are far much higher in the level of the countries in which are our inputs. It's our output basically where we have some, I would say, inefficiencies. And by having such a plan where everybody agreed to it, is by trying to improve your efficiency in the system. So with the same inputs you put, the government put, the private sector and the people, you have a far much better output, which will have a higher impact on the society and the economy, inshallah.
We'll take a short break and be right back. Innovation is future new oil. Oman to be among the top 40 most innovative countries in the world by 2020 and among the top 20 most innovative countries by 2040. You are listening to the National Innovation Strategy.
Now I actually understand. So basically, it's when you talk about innovation, we always think about the end result or the individuals who come up with the ideas and being innovative. But you want to go, the Research Council with the strategy wants to go to the grassroots level.
Sure.
So to the foundations itself.
Definitely, because again, when we speak about innovation, we speak about a mindset.
Mm.
It's a mindset of people who are innovative, where they basically will go and try to find solution, no matter what, how simple it is, how complicated it is, rather than to wait to find somebody to come and find the solution for them.
Mm.
And Omanis, for a very long period of time, they were innovative. Mm. Well, there is no doubt about it. And when we go to talk about our forefathers and what they have been achieved, and when we talk as Omanis about our history, and we take pride about our history, and we take our and even today what have been achieved was achieved by Omani with the help also of the expertise in different, but Omanis also were the main change agent of this recent what have going on. So naturally, historically you have it, now you have it. So obviously the new generation, the future also have to have it. The difference is that the history and the current came out of necessity, because you have to do it.
Right.
The future ones also have to change the mindset in order for them to maintain and continue on the same path of their fathers and their forefathers. They have to have a change mind of, well, this is our problem. We have to change it, and we can change it, obviously. We have to change it, and that's it's a mindset.
And the challenges have changed.
Oh, definitely. I mean, there is no doubt now. Basically, it's not about food and all that. There is much challenges, even in the economy. Now we have been blessed of having oil and gas for the past 47, like other our brothers in the Gulf and other countries where that provided most of the return and what we call it of what we have today in terms of everything, infrastructure and the government. But again, what we have seen in the past couple of years, which basically the National Innovation Strategy from the beginning predicted that the oil, once the oil process go down, there is a crisis, there will be a big changes at the end of the day. So the next step is that we're trying to keep the new generation to thinking to survive and have the same living standard and prosperity with new ways, away in from oil and gas, because basically, as it's known internationally, there is now a shift away from oil as high carbon resources for power resources.
Renewable energy, for example.
Whatever it is at the end of the day. Yeah.
So how many teams have been involved in developing the strategy? You said you are actually meeting different ministries, different entities, so to make sure that journey is same for everybody and everyone is involved.
Yes, but I think we have to understand the National Innovation Strategy started with what we call STIP report, or STIP review, which is science, technology, and IP, which is policies, which is done by ANCTA. It's one of the chapters of the United Nations.
Mm-hmm.
What we did, I think the whole thinking of the innovation strategy, innovation Oman, started with what we call it national research strategy, which started in 2008. And that's where we said, okay, innovation should be a very important, a very central of Oman, and we need to do something about it. So basically said, let's bring these international experts, let them scan what we have in terms of our strength, weaknesses, what our opportunities, what we have, what we don't have, and lay to them what we want. So we brought a team from the ANCTA. We applied for STEP review because it's funded by them and basically each country. So alhamdulillah, we were the first country in the Gulf to do that. And basically there is a revision every 10 years for that. So basically they came and basically the expertise, they led a team, which also we have a committee for that. We have different members from different ministries. Then the different team members, they went to visit different leadership in the private sector, in the government. They met minister and their secretaries. They met academic, they met researcher. They met a lot of CEOs in a lot of companies. And they come and said, okay, this is exactly the opportunities, what you have, the challenges, where's the weakness in your education system, in your research system, what have can be done. That process basically took almost 2 to 3 years, basically, where they come they compiled a report where everybody's going on. That report was basically introduced in 2014 to the NCTAD as the official STIP review of Oman, would have been acknowledged in the UN, which is the NCTAD. And then basically, there is also a mission from the NCTAD at the highest level came and introduced and gave a presentation about it to the Minister Council. Mm-hmm. That's what have been done. Mm. Once that have been identified, then we said, okay, what's the best way? The next stage is to start to draw the innovation strategy based on those challenges in different areas. Then we decided there was a national committee, which is headed by His Highness Sayyid and also have members like His Excellency Dr. Ali Snedi, His Excellency Mohammed Zubair, Her Excellency Madiha, and a few others, which basically His Excellency Dr. Fahad and His Excellency Sheikh Abdullah Al-Bakri. These are members of the National Innovation Strategy. So they gave us the green light to go and sit. We formulated the strategy members. We had actually, we divided the strategy into four main pillars: human capital, IP, and then we have what you call it economic diversification, and they have another pillar which we call it communication communication, which we identified that there is a lack of communication. So these pillars we brought, we asked the different ministries and different people to nominate the right people to the right things, and we have common ones, and basically those different pillars met to decide and discuss what's the challenges and all that stuff. And then we have also another team, we call it a quality assurance team, which is led by people from here. The beauty of this, as we feel that it's done by Omanis, we never brought experts from outside because we thought this is our challenge, it's our problem. In order for us to succeed, we have to see the future. We have to, no one better than us understands. And we said to the NCTAD, we will bring you later on when the documents come. As a matter of fact, we had a challenge with the NCTAD team when it came. They said, okay, how many pages you want this strategy? I said, we are not doing that. I said, why? I said, we're going to bring everybody. I said, we cannot do that. What they want to have six experts sit in a room for 7 days and draw things. We said, we are not doing that. We are bringing our own teams. We believe as Omanis, we have the talent, we have the competence to do that. In order for us, everybody have to come, no matter how they feel, how things going on. So in total, we have in the first, as a team members, we have 77 mm-hmm. team members okay. from all sectors. Those were divided in the seven pillars. Then we asked the different pillars, chairmen. We have reporters, we have chairmen, we had heads. Those were not from the TRC. We mm-hmm. said, for economic diversification, said, okay, the central bank, you are responsible about it. They bring their economists. For example, for HR, we either ask somebody from the Ministry of Education or somebody from the HR, from PDO to head that department. For communication, we ask somebody also from the Minister Council cabinets to identify all the IP, Fatma Al-Ghazali, who is in the Ministry of Trade and Commerce, she is dealing with that because that's their core businesses. Mm-hmm. And we said, you are the one, you're going to lead this and basically you're going to implement it. So basically don't come, tell us mm-hmm. exactly what you want. Tell us this is our plan and they, you execute it.
So they use their own expertise.
It have to be.
Yes.
Because again, if you don't bring the right people, to me, the way I said is that it's much easy. It's like putting a plan of your own things and asking somebody to execute it. Mm-hmm. No one will do that for you. Definitely not. But basically what we said, this is a common cause. This is part of your core business. This is exactly what you are trying to do. Just put it in try to implement it in much wider perspectives. You know, where you have to understand that your role does not end here. It's actually start there. Mm-hmm. You know, see the point. It's the whole thing at the end of the day. And basically, everybody was involved. we had also, once we agreed on the concept, we have a workshop, open workshop for 2 days over weekends. Basically, we asked everybody to come and participate in those, no matter what, to discuss it, and then basically come with them to agree on the concepts and go on. And that's the way we drafted our the strategy, where people, once that have been drafted, we gave it to the quality assurance, which is basically, we have one from TRC, and then we have also different expertise from the private sector and some of the universities here in Oman, and to tell us exactly, there is the red flags whenever there is a red flag regarding some of the areas. Of course, the quality assurance also reflect the different pillars in which they have to also to have the competencies to challenge all those things going on. That took us almost a year. We started in May 2016, we finished in 2017 as drafting it. Once we drafted, we gave it to the National Committee, then we presented once we finished to the Mr. Cabinet, where the whole cabinet was there. Mm-hmm. We presented our plan, what we need, challenges. And then once it had been really approved at the census, that we lagged where our vision, how we want to do it, what's the strategy vision. Once we that said, we have been given the green light to go ahead and start implementing, contacting the different ministries and different things going on. So that's where we are, actually.
So this is the stage we are right
now. Yes, yes.
On the roadmap.
Yes.
We'll take a short break and be right back. National Innovation Strategy Project, sharing the vision and sharing the responsibility. You are listening to the National Innovation Strategy.
You explained to us about the beginning and the challenges and the study that was conducted. Just before we conclude this edition of Innovation Roadmap, what would you say for us to reflect on until we join next week? What are the problem areas or areas that needed development, extra work on?
Well, frankly speaking, and I don't see any challenges. I think it's always in mindset. If we be frank and honest, we have so many activities going on, and that's the whole essence and the spirit of the innovation strategy, is that let us bring all these efforts, all these strategies which is there in place, which people are working, they're working very hard for it. Let's see it in a holistic approach where we see each one. I use this metaphor. I see the innovation strategy is the engine. And in engine, when you open it, there is small parts, no matter there is small parts, there is big parts. But all these different parts and they have to work fit together to give you the moving and the whole thing. So if we look at it in the form of the innovation strategy is the engine, but we cannot say that there is the lack. This is one thing. The other thing is that we are trying to be realistic. We are trying to say there is always a limits on resources. There is no such unlimited resources, mm-hmm. no matter whether it's human capital or economical things. Let's make of what we have on the ground, what it could be better, put it together, work it to the best, and try our best. And that's why we're trying, because we understand and we have believed that the road is long, because that's what we wanted. We don't want a very fast track where it gives us something which is results now, and later on it fade out. We want something, we want change in culture, we want to have a mindset change, we have to put it in our generation, and also we are making changes. We are making changes in the mindset of the people. Alhamdulillah, and it's a blessing that the oil prices came down. It showed the people what we are thinking about. Mm. Now we are in what we say the control mode, because people now think of trying to achieve their goals in different sector, in the private sector, in the government sector, in everything. With the minimum, with the resources. And that's the essence of the innovation strategy, is that you try to achieve goals, usually the previous mindset is that we have the money, why we cannot do it? We will plan it. So basically, now we said we don't have the money, but we can achieve those.
Yes.
And that's the mindset of the people, is that trying and aspiring and trying their best to achieve the goals with whatever resources they have. And that's the whole essence of the knowledge economy. It's the mind.
And the eagerness is there.
And the mind. The mindset, you have the mind and the talent to achieve your goals with the minimal resources you have. It's the same thing.
And so the timing came at the perfect.
I think the timing, and exactly. And I think from the beginning, when I say I joined the Research Council in 2013, all what have been said in terms of the National Research Strategy of this STEP review and the ENCTAD report was set by my predecessors here. Mm-hmm. So basically I came and continued. And alhamdulillah, all that hard work and thinking, planning, hard work, or everybody have been involved in that and still continuing, is giving fruits. And that's the talent. We just keep continuing pushing. We are not saying that things will be much easier, because we are changing mindset. We are changing people attitude. We are actually laying the foundation and walking through in a journey where we never been before. So we have to learn, adapt, apply, and see, and that's the whole essence of the innovation strategy. It's, there is no an end. Actually, this is only the start. We hope that it will continue with and the momentum, inshallah, we have the confidence that it will be built, with the with the effort. So basically, to see the effort of everybody, I think that's their effort is appreciated. There is always will be things will never work according to our own aspiration and planning and thinking. But also we have to understand there is always like limitation, there is priority, there is so many things going on.
But it's a living thing, so we...
It is. It's part of life. Yes. Yeah.
Well, it's been excellent, your introduction to us about the National Innovation Strategy. We look forward to joining you next week.
Inshallah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Our guest, His Highness Sayyid Dr. Fahad bin Al-Jalanda Al-Sayed, Assistant Secretary General for Innovation Development at the Research Council, Chairman of the Supervisory Committee of the National Innovation Strategy.
National Innovation Strategy. The Nation Station Oman FM, with the cooperation of the Research Council, presents Innovation Roadmap, an introduction to National Innovation Strategy.